I was at Spurs, Tottenham Hotspurs.
Yeah.
I was watching a game against Arsenal. And this bloke come up to me and said hello.
Oh, no.
And I thought, Christ!
Yeah.
You know, this bloke come up to me and says hello.
Provocative fucker.
Fucking provocative.
Yeah.
I said, what do you mean, hello? And you know what he came back with?
Yeah.
He said, I just meant, hello. I said, oh, I can suss you out
right,
for a start.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, get this in the bollocks for a start. So I kicked him right in the balls. He fell to the floor. As he fell to the floor, he said, ugh. I said, don't you ugh me, mate.
Yeah, like he comes in with hello and then goes out with ugh.
Yeah, I said, don't you ugh me, mate. And I kicked his fucking teeth in.
Yeah.
Then he went, ah. And I said, fucking hell.
I said, this is fucking too much, eh?
Don't you fucking ugh me.
Yeah.
And do you know, he still had the audacity to come out with, I'm dying. Well, what could I say to that? I just walked away, I left the situation. I wasn't going to be, you know, put upon in that
you
way.
You weren't going to be dictated to, were you?
Well, no, why should I be dictated
exactly.
to?
Long story short, I come flying out and fuck me out of the frying pan into the fire. I landed straight in the fucking toilet.
I'll be back. Did I tell you about Damien?
No, you didn't.
Well, he had a terrible blow last Tuesday.
I had a lovely blow last Tuesday.
Well, no, you told me. You told me all about that. But Damien was in terrible trouble because the people from the ecology, you know, the environmental people come round. And he was just off to the laundrette to take his wife runs down there.
Oh, yeah, I know. He does that every Wednesday, doesn't he?
No, not every Wednesday, every 2 years.
Oh.
He's been wearing his wife runs for about 2 years, you know. And every 2 years he thinks, well, you know, might as well get them cleaned up, you know, get a proper job done on them.
Get them scraped.
And precisely.
The Lord Humungous, the warrior of the wasteland, the Ayatollah of rock and roller!
I am gravely disappointed. Again, you have made me unleash my dogs of war. Look around you. There has been too much violence, too much pain. Just walk away. And I spare you lives. Just walk away, and there will be an end to the horror.
Anyway, these people from the Ministry of Environment came round, and they said, excuse me, before you take these wife ants down to the laundromat, we'd like to inspect them.
Why not?
And they... I found the only two living examples of the barking toad.
The barking toad?
Yeah, everybody thought the barking toad was extinct, but no! There was two of them in Damien's wife ranch.
Was it the barking and Romford toad, or the...
No, no, it's not called the barking toad because it lives in Barking. It's called the barking toad because it goes woof. And they said, this is an endangered species, and they've been flourishing there. And he said, well, I've got these barking toads in my wife ants, what do I do? And they said, well, we want them to breed. And you'll have to keep these wife ants on for at least 4 years.
Yeah.
Because we're hoping these two toads will, you know, get the horn and get in the mood and, you know, spawn some more. The man from the Environment Ministry, he thought the reason why these barking toads had taken refuge in Damien's wife ants was because of the similarity of the bollocks that were hanging there in the first place.
Oh, maybe they'd gone there thinking they could mate with the bollocks.
With the bollocks. And indeed, they had been trying to mate with the bollocks, which, you know, Damien used to wake up in the night thinking, hello, what's going on?
And
it was barking toads at his bollocks.
Yeah.
But he's got to keep them in there for another 2 years in the hope that they'll spawn. And, you know, the spawn will trickle down to his socks.
Do you think, it's possible that the barking toads could, mate with his bark? Because, that'd be interesting.
Well, then you get a species called the web-footed barking bollocks. Which, would be a new thing, wouldn't it? Web-footed barking bollocks. But, still, if it's an endangered species, I say, fuck 'em.